Good morning, everyone, and welcome to St. John Youth's. Please stand and join in singing number 466, At the Name of Jesus, number 466. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, every tongue confess him, King of glory now. Jesus is Lord, King of glory now. He emptied himself as a slave.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. On this Saturday, we are preparing to enter into the feast of Christ the King. That's tomorrow. So tonight is the vigil for Christ the King, where we recognize that Jesus is the King of the universe, Christ is the King of our hearts, and He is our joy. The Father sent His Son into the world to bring joy into a world that had fallen into sorrow. So today the Mass that we're celebrating is Mary, cause of our joy. When she said yes to the angel, when she said yes to God, the incarnation took place within her, and Jesus brings joy into this world. So through Mary's yes, we honor her as the cause of our joy. For the times in our own lives where we have not said yes, maybe we have resisted Jesus and His mercy in our lives. For the times that we have perpetuated sorrow in the world, we ask God for His mercy and forgiveness.
Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison.
Let us pray. Lord, our God, you were pleased to bring joy to the world through the incarnation of your Son. Grant that we who honor His mother, the cause of our joy, may always walk in the way of your commandments, with our hearts set on true and lasting joy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, heard a voice from heaven speak to me. Here are my two witnesses. There are two olive trees and two lampstands that stand before the Lord of the earth. If anyone wants to harm them, fire comes out of their mouths and devours their enemies. In this way, anyone wanting to harm them is sure to be slain. They have the power to close up the sky so that no rain can fall during the time of their prophesying. They also have the power to turn water into blood and to afflict the earth with any plague as often as they wish. Then, when they have finished their testimony, the beast that comes up from the abyss will wage war against them and conquer them and kill them. Their corpses will lie in the main street of the great city, which has the symbolic names Sodom and Egypt, where indeed their Lord was crucified. Those from every people, tribe, tongue, and nation will gaze on their corpses for 3.5 days, and they will not allow their corpses to be buried. The inhabitants of the earth will gloat over them and be glad and exchange gifts, because these two prophets tormented the inhabitants of the earth. But after 3.5 days, a breath of life from God entered them. When they stood on their feet, great fear fell on those who saw them. Then they heard a loud voice from heaven say to them, "Come up here." So they went up to heaven in a cloud as their enemies looked on. The word of the Lord. Blessed be the Lord, my rock. Blessed be the Lord, my rock. Blessed be the Lord, my rock, who trains my hands for battle, my fingers for war. Blessed be the Lord, my rock, my mercy and my fortress, my stronghold, my deliverer, my shield in whom I trust, who subdues my people under me. Blessed be the Lord, my rock. O God, I will sing a new song to you with a 10-string lyre. I will chant your praise, you who give victory to kings and deliver David, your servant, from the evil sword. Blessed be the Lord, my rock.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Our Savior Jesus Christ has destroyed death and brought life to light through the gospel. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Some Sadducees, those who deny that there is a resurrection, came forward and put this question to Jesus, saying, "Teacher, Moses wrote for us, if someone's brother dies leaving a wife but no child, his brother must take the wife and raise up descendants for his brother. Now there were 7 brothers. The first married a woman but died childless. Then the second and the third married her, and likewise all the seven died childless. Finally, the woman also died. Now at the resurrection, whose wife will that woman be? For all seven had been married to her. Jesus said to them, "The children of this age marry and remarry. But those who are deemed worthy to attain to the coming age and to the resurrection of the dead neither marry nor are given in marriage. They can no longer die, for they are like angels. And they are the children of God, because they are the ones who will rise. That the dead will rise, even Moses made known in the passage about the bush when he called, 'Lord, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob.' And he is not God of the dead, but of the living. For to him, all are alive." Some of the scribes said in reply, "Teacher, you have answered well." And they no longer dared to ask him anything. The Gospel of the Lord. It said that Jesus, in a certain sense, was bait for Satan, for the great beast. Jesus was and is the Son of God, the innocent lamb. Satan had gotten to a point where he was so invested in the sin and disruption and disobedience that he had to carry it all the way through. And he couldn't resist, Satan could not resist putting Jesus to death. Except this was his downfall. Because in the death, Jesus put to death the great beast. Jesus won the victory by being put to death. When Jesus was on the cross, he took all of that anger, all of that hatred, all of the disobedience, he just drained it all out, and he won. For a short while, Jesus was buried into the ground, and it appeared to everyone that Satan won, that evil won the day. But that wasn't true. God raised Jesus up to new life, to the resurrection. And that is great cause for joy. It's great cause for joy. When Jesus came into the world, he was incarnate, there was great joy. Mary rejoiced, and she went off with joy, with haste. She went to visit her cousin Elizabeth. Again and again, we hear of the joy that was filled in Mary's life because of Jesus. God is bringing that joy to all of us. So even in the depths, the darkness of death, even there, God is bringing joy and hope and new life. And so in the resurrection, we ultimately rejoice because we see that there is an end to all of the sin and corruption and death in the world. Someone once said that if you haven't received the joy, or if things haven't worked out properly, you haven't gotten to the end of the story. If we only stop at Good Friday, when Jesus died, we haven't gotten to the end of the story. We haven't gotten to the resurrection yet. And so in our own lives, maybe we've experienced suffering, we've experienced darkness, we experienced the corruption of the world, and maybe our spirits just feel weary. How much longer can we endure this? How much longer can we take this? The story hasn't finished yet. Because there will be a resurrection, there will be a new life, and we have to let it run its course. We have to trust and go into the tomb with Jesus so that we could rise with Jesus to new life and to his joy. So we stand, and with joyful hearts, we offer our prayers and petitions to our Heavenly Father. For our leaders in the church, that their prophetic witness may effectively challenge the world and leaven it from within, we pray to the Lord. For the gift of peace, that conflicts may be worked through in a way that will address the needs of all involved, especially the most vulnerable, we pray to the Lord. That we may be faithful witnesses to the Lord, lamps who give light to all and stand shining and glowing before the Lord of all the earth, we pray to the Lord. For all who have asked our prayers, and all who are in a season of special need at this time, that our Blessed Lady, Mother of Mercy and Cause of Joy, may come to them with consolation and healing, we pray to the Lord. For all our loved ones who have died, that the God for whom everyone is alive may purify them quickly and make them an angel of comfort to those they have left behind for a little while, we pray to the Lord. Pray for the intentions of this Mass. Pray for the intention of C.V., John and Smitha, and Brian Gutierrez, for all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord. Dear Heavenly Father, you sent the angel to our Blessed Mother, whom she said yes to your plan and became the cause of our joy. We ask that through our joy, Jesus Christ, you can hear and answer these prayers. Amen.
Let us all join in singing number 696, In Every Age, number 696. You love me.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, receive the offerings of your joyful church, and as you have given us every good gift in Christ the Savior, born of the Immaculate Virgin, grant us a share in his harvest of everlasting joy through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father. And as we honor the memory of the Blessed Virgin, the daughter of your love, to proclaim with fitting praise the greatness of your name. Her blessed birth heralded joy for all the world. Her virgin motherhood brought forth the true light, the source of all joy. Her hidden life brings light and warmth to all the churches of the world. Her passing into glory raised her to the heights of heaven, where, as our sister and our mother, she waits for us with loving care until we too enjoy the vision of your glory forever. In our joy, we sing to your glory with all the choirs of angels. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and cause of our joy, with dear Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, with St. John Eudes and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. The Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that with the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Let us join in our communion hymn. It's number 614, How Great Thou Art, number 614. Thank you.
Let us pray. Confirm in our minds the mysteries of the true faith, we pray, O Lord, so that confessing that he who was conceived of the Virgin Mary is true God and true man, we may, through the saving power of his resurrection, merit to attain eternal joy through Christ our Lord. The eternal joy, it's not just a passing moment. It's not just something that feels good and then passes away. It's the eternal joy. And so as we continue to respond to God's will in our lives, we receive joy. We receive Christ. We're moving in Christ himself. And we ask our Blessed Mother for her help to say yes to God. Hail Mary. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless and keep you in his sacred heart. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. And our closing hymn is number 598. Sing a new song, number 598.